Hello everyone, welcome to Information with Tepiso. I am Tepiso Rangwejana and you're tuned in to Monday the 27th of November 2023's Rhapsody Reading. Today's title is Partakers and Dispensers of His Life. While you're still at that, kindly remember to subscribe to this channel, turn on the notification bell so that you get notified every time I upload a video. Like and share these videos with your loved ones. Don't forget to comment in the comment section below. The opening scripture is Romans 8 verse 11, which reads as follows. But if the spirit of him that raised up Jesus from the dead dwell in you, he that raised up Christ from the dead shall also quicken your mortal bodies by his spirit that dwelleth in you. Pastor says, in relation to our opening scripture above, an important question to ask would be, does the Holy Spirit live in you? If the answer is yes, then it means the Holy Spirit has given life to your hitherto death-doomed or death-prone body. Hallelujah. That means there's no death in your body. Life works in you. The Holy Spirit is the spirit of life. He is the life giver. And because he lives in you, he has given life to your physical body. Often we say the Christian isn't an ordinary person. He's one with the Lord, on the same mission and purpose with the Lord. In John 10, verse 10, the Lord Jesus declared, I have come that they may have life and have it in the full. He came to give eternal life to those who would believe in him. Now that you are born again, you have become one spirit with the Lord. We see the scripture reference in 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 17. The Bible calls Jesus a life-giving spirit. 1 Corinthians 15, verse 45 to 47 with the NIV Bible version says, so it is written, the first man Adam became a living being, the last Adam a life-giving spirit, that is Christ Jesus. The spiritual did not come first, but the natural, and after that, the spiritual. The first man was of the dust of the earth, the second man from heaven. That also makes you a life-giving spirit, because as he is, so are you. We see the scripture reference in 1 John chapter 4, verse 17. Not only has he made you a partaker of his life, you are also a dispenser or distributor of eternal life. It's your life's purpose to bring the lost into the life of righteousness through the gospel. 2 Timothy chapter 1 verse 10 lets us know that Jesus Christ has abolished death and brought life and immortality to light through the gospel. Eternal life is unveiled through the preaching of the gospel. As people listen to you preach, eternal life, which encompasses salvation, prosperity, and the righteousness of God, is unveiled to them. The Lord Jesus said in John 20, verse 21, as my Father has sent me, even so send I you. He has chosen you to manifest the God life to the nations. He sent you as a bearer of his gospel, to bring others into the glorious life in Christ. Praise God. Let us take the confession. Say, as Jesus is, so am I. I'm a life-giving spirit, a dispenser and distributor of eternal life and the eternal realities of the kingdom. I bring joy to many today as I share the gospel with them, which is the power of God to transform their lives and catapult them into their inheritance in Christ. Hallelujah. For further studies, we read 2 Timothy chapter 1, verse 9 to 10, John 3, verse 16, and 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 20. If you're on the two-year Bible reading plan, today we read John 15, verse 11 to 19, and 1 Chronicles chapter 27, all of it. If you're on the one-year Bible reading plan, remember to read 2 Peter chapter 1, all of it, and Ezekiel chapter 37 to chapter 38, all of it. Ladies and gentlemen, we've come to the end of today's Rhapsody reading. Do join us tomorrow as we read the message titled, Your Confessions Rule You. Praise the Lord. This is Information with Tsepiso. Thank you so much for tuning in and have a beautiful day. We'll meet tomorrow with tomorrow's message.